Hi, my name's Maria Makrides. I'm the Executive Director of the South Australian Health and Medical Research Institute, SAHMRI. Previous to that was the theme leader for SAHMRI Women and Kids. I started at SAHMRI about 10 years ago. I've had the great privilege of seeing SAHMRI as well as the theme grow from a few people to now over 700 in our SAHMRI community, involving our partners with the universities in South Australia. Given SAHMRI's short life, over 10 years, we have actually had some amazing impacts. I'll just highlight three. In quite different areas, one being the huge advancements in the care of people with chronic myeloid leukaemia, changing it from formerly being a death sentence to essentially a chronic disease that can be well treated, which is a fantastic achievement. Another being the wonderful work that's actually happened in with our Aboriginal Health Equity team. The theme basically started off setting the groundwork with a huge framework about how best to do research in partnership with Indigenous communities in an appropriate and culturally respectful way. That framework, the Accord, has been used throughout the Institute, and now we're seeing big changes in the way chronic disease care is applied for Aboriginal people and set up of other major projects. The third is being in maternal and child health and the understanding of how omega-3 fatty acids, or fish oil fats if you like, have important roles to play in determining the length of pregnancy and using that as a strategy to reduce the risk of having preterm births for women who happen to be low in these omega-3 fatty acids. We've often described our culture at SAHMRI as being fast, focused, friendly, flexible and fun. So the five F's, if you like, that have been used by other startup corporations to really engender innovation and engage interest. The culture has been one about collaboration, the ability to take a risk. Doesn't always work out, but the taking of risks and learning from the things that don't quite work as well as the things that do work has been really important in being able to make those advancements relatively quickly. The opportunities for research at SAHMRI are wonderful. For early career researchers, the ability to work with people who are well established and forge their own career are wonderful. It's also a bit of a magnet to bring people from overseas who are already established in what skills they have and bring their skills and expertise and grow the capacity for Adelaide and importantly for South Australia. In terms of future patient care, I guess our main interest at SAHMRI is having evidence-based care that's driven by research. If I look into a crystal ball, it's really about having more precision or precise approaches for both treatment and prevention of common diseases that afflict our communities. One of the big ones, of course, is cancer. And the opportunity for research with Australia's first proton therapy treatments being available here in South Australia is going to be hugely important for continuous improvement and research. Of course, we're already undertaking some research in trying to work out the best models of care and how that compares to what we currently do in terms of sending people overseas for proton therapy. There's a fair bit of history in terms of wanting to bring a proton therapy centre to Australia. Discussions as far back, I understand, as 2014. The proton therapy centre that will be available in Adelaide, South Australia, will be the first one in the Southern Hemisphere. really designed to treat hard to access cancers, particularly for children in the brain, where conventional radiotherapy does lead to significant side effects and potentially significant long-term damage for these children. And so the proton therapy will be a major advance and hopefully stop these families needing to go overseas for seeking that treatment. We will be celebrating SAHMRI's 10-year anniversary towards the end of November. We have a great week of celebrations planned, an open day to welcome the South Australian community into SAHMRI, for them to see firsthand some of the great work that happens here. A celebration for the SAHMRI community, our staff and partners, planned for the actual anniversary of the opening of the building. Then followed by a celebration with our supporters and donors, SAHMRI being a not-for-profit charity organisation. We're incredibly reliant on our donors and supporters. And finally, a dinner to honour our executive director, our first inaugural executive director, as well as the other people who have been involved in SAHMRI over the longer term.